Hello, my friends. It's Push Tech once again. So today we have a very important topic before us. I want to introduce a powerful mobile app that has been in existence for more than 5 years, but since most of us don't know how to use it, we've been using it for some time now, and it's very wonderful. So let me share this idea to you. You don't have a tracker, you don't have a sat finder like this, and it will be burdensome for you to take out your decoder, your receiver outside with your screen outside and use it for tracking. You've been doing that before, but I want to introduce this app that will make it easy for you. You don't need to bring out your screen out. This app, this G-MScreen, will act as a screen. Whatever is inside the decoder, your signal quality, your signal strength, you can be able to view it from this G-MScreen and do your tracking easily. That's the purpose of this lecture. So your decoder screen will be seen on this app. So you'll be tracking. You can take it outside, maybe 10 meters away from where your decoder is, via Wi-Fi. Once it's connected to Wi-Fi, you can take this one out, your phone out, and be viewing your tracking from outside. So it can also act like a remote control. You have a bad remote control and you have this app, then you are good to go. This app can remotely control your screen. Can we control your screen from this mobile app from your phone? So this is all about. We are going to go through it quickly. But first of all, what do you need for this app to function very well? You need a decoder that is Wi-Fi enabled. So if you want to get a decoder, please go for a decoder that is Wi-Fi enabled. Don't go for a decoder that there's no Wi-Fi enabled. Whether the Wi-Fi is inbuilt or the Wi-Fi adapter is outside, just make sure it's Wi-Fi enabled. So if you don't have an inbuilt Wi-Fi but it's enabled, you can use an external adapter to connect. So how does it work? It simply works this: your decoder will be connected to a Wi-Fi, and your phone that contains the GM screen will also be connected to the same Wi-Fi for it to function. Hold on, take a deep breath, and let me go through the lecture with you. Okay, we continue from where we stopped. So want to connect our decoder to this Wi-Fi, then we'll connect our phone to the Wi-Fi. So first of all, go to network. Depending on your decoder type you're using, go to Wi-Fi, search for the network. So this push, click on push. It's connecting, waiting for the connection. So it has successfully connected to. I'm through with my decoder. Next thing is for me to go to my handset. This is my G. You can see this is my G-screen. This is my G-screen. GM screen, it has not connected. Once it's connected, under this STB list, you will see the list of decoder, my decoder name. So I have to go to my own Wi-Fi here. Go to my Wi-Fi here. Go to my Wi-Fi. I connect to my Wi-Fi. No. Click the Wi-Fi here. It's push. Click push here. Obtaining connected also. So I go back to the app. You can see, so I've connected my decoder and my phone on this push network. So both your phone and your decoder must be on the same network before you can see. So the decoder name has come up, T60 forever, with my serial number. Click on it. Once I click on it, please wait. You can see I'm under UTSAR 16A. This is what I have here. UTSAR 16A. UTSAR 16A is what I have on my screen. Click it for better view. Exactly what I have here is what this app is displaying here to me. Now let's see. I have CRO TV here. I have Send TV. I have CRO TV here. I have Send TV. You can see exactly what is on the screen here is what in the screen here. Another thing I have to look at is I have two network. I have if I click on my list of network here, my satellites here, I have just two satellites. UTSAR 16A and Astra 28.2. I come to this place also, you see, I click on here, this place. It is the same thing I have here also. Astra 28.2E and UTSAR 16A. Good. So let me search the channel. Quickly change the channel. Let me go to my Gospel TV from this place. My Gospel TV. My Gospel TV here. Or any of them. Not necessarily my Gospel TV. Let me change to Power. Power TV. I've changed to Power TV now. Power TV is up here. I want to change this one now to whatever I change here is what will appear here. So I'm controlling this now from this place. I'm controlling it from this place. You can see the movements. 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 And she's in the movements. So it's a very good app for you. If you don't have the remote control is bad, you can use it as a remote control. So let's now go to the tracker function. For you to use the tracker function, you want to use this one as a satellite finder. There's another option here where you have more. This place, click more. Then you go to the DVBF finder. Click on this place. You can see it's making noise. You can see the signal strength. You can see. So once you just use it, you can choose the list of satellites you want. Choose the list of satellites you want. Choose like this, click on it. So if the transmitter, you come to the transmitter here. Click on the transmitter. You can even add your own transmitter. Dissect, it has dissect switch. Car dissects, LMA type, LMA power, and the rest of them. So by the time you can even edit your channel lists. So let me go back to the one I've got signal already, 16, 16, 16, 16, 16, 16, 16, 16. 16 16. Can I choose the transmitter? Let me use 10 10 804. Wow, what a beautiful experience, comrades. It's left for you to go out there now and start using this great, this wonderful app, this wonderful GM screen to start tracking and to start using as a site finder. Don't forget to like this video. Don't forget to share and don't forget to subscribe. I love you all. Bye bye.